People often blanket animation under one roof, potentially leaving the impression that most animated films have a similar look and feel to that of a Pixar, Disney, or DreamWorks production. But the truth is, animation as a medium of filmmaking spans many genres, tells many stories, and as a result, is presented in many different ways. So which animation style is best? Well, it's not quite as black and white as that. In fact, what it really boils down to is that you should always choose the animation style that best facilitates the story you're trying to tell. To expand upon this, let's explore a wide range of different styles that I think work really well for their respective films. Or if you prefer, you can just sit back and watch some stunning visuals. Regardless, away we go. Interestingly enough, I want to start us off with Nick Park's Wallace and Gromit. I think the story behind A Grand Day Out is pretty inspiring, and although by today's standards it appears rough around the edges, I think that actually aids it in setting the silly tone Wallace and Gromit films are so well known for. You can see the influence of Wallace and Gromit across almost all stop-motion animation today, and I think Aardman have been very influential in the popularization of this style. A prime example of this inspiration would be Laika Studios, most famous for the 2009 movie Coraline, which utilizes the sometimes rigid and awkward movement of stop-motion to set a creepy and uneasy tone. On the other hand, there's Kubo and the Two Strings, which uses the rugged nature of stop-motion to create unbelievably beautiful scenes. I think Kubo and the Two Strings' origami aesthetic is particularly clever, expanding the backstory of the film in an entertaining way, whilst just generally looking incredible. Not to mention when this is paired with nice lighting, such as in the lantern scene at the end of the film. Speaking of nice lighting, that brings me to Wes Anderson. I covered him in depth in my previous video, but what I want to highlight here is his use of silhouettes. Silhouetting can be really useful when wanting to show off locations, or when wanting to portray a character as isolated or lonely. Much like Aardman and Laika, Wes Anderson uses the imperfect charm of stop motion to full effect as he creates very human characters with flaws and shortcomings, as well as repurposing practical effects to present a caricatured version of real life. If you're looking for another style which utilizes practical effects really well, then you should check out the short film Lost and Found. With only the use of simple materials like wool and string, directors Andrew Goldsmith and Bradley Slabe managed to tell a compelling and heartbreaking story about two incredibly cute stuffed toys that are willing to risk their lives for each other. Another short I'm very attached to that approaches animation in a different way is Pixar's Piper. This is possibly some of the most impressive realism I've seen in animation, outside of those terrible Disney remakes that are completely void of soul or passion. The water, the sand, and the feathers are all incredibly intricate and detailed. This works in Piper because the subject the film is focusing on is grounded within a set location that's simple and identifiable, aka the beach. There seems to be an obsession with hyper-realism at the moment in animation, and story can sometimes end up taking a back seat. In Piper, they've managed to find a happy medium between these features. And also, this bird is potentially the most adorable thing I've ever seen with my eyes. The crab characters are excellent too. It would be stupid of me if I didn't mention Pixar throughout this video. There's a reason computer-generated 3D animation caught on, and has now become the most popular medium of animated filmmaking in the West. From Finding Nemo, to Incredibles, to Up, to Monsters, Inc., Pixar have made some fantastic-looking films, and I think my favourite out of all of them is Wall-E. The first 30 minutes of Wall-E is a masterclass in visual storytelling, and for a robot with no dialogue aside from two words, Wall-E is an incredibly expressive and emotionally vivid character. They make flying through space using a fire extinguisher look gorgeous, and just in general, I think it's the exact type of movie that's suited to Pixar's style of animation. Now, here's where I have to apologize slightly, because pretty much all of my favorite 2D animation styles are Japanese. And I know what you're thinking, well, what a weeb this guy is. But listen, I think it's not unfair to say that there's a bit of a stigma against anime. Of course, you're allowed to have your opinion on anime, but I do think there's a tendency to fall into the it's all the same kind of mentality, which just isn't true. As a result, because the art style, which has been developed over more than 100 years now, is so synonymous with the genre, it feels like the actual artistry behind it is kind of overlooked. And as I'm sure you'll be unsurprised to hear, I really like the way most anime looks. I think it's a very aesthetically pleasing interesting way of drawing. Studio Ghibli is a great example. The craftsmanship and talent that goes into the way these films look is amazing. Every Studio Ghibli movie has a multitude of beautiful watercolor-like shots, but that doesn't mean they stick to the same formula each time. Castle in the Sky is grand and vast, with large sprawling clouds and vibrant green areas of trees and plants. Kiki's Delivery Service is more quaint and cutesy. Ponyo is very cartoony, whereas The Wind Rises is more polished with lens flares and reflections. Even within the same broad style, when you're watching each film, smaller things like the saturation of the colours, the thickness of the lines, the shapes of the characters' faces can change the tone of a film more than you would think. In terms of other anime styles, there's that of Makoto Shinkai, with films like Your Name, Garden of Words, and Weathering with You. I particularly like the thread scene from Your Name, in which the colours become all neon and the drawing goes sketchy and rough. I think it's a really interesting way of presenting a vision or dream sequence. On the other end of the spectrum, you've got series like Death Note, which, as the name implies, is much darker and shadowy. Or there's Attack on Titan, which is very pop-arty with distinguished thick lines and harsh shading. And then there's a more obscure series that I like called Fisherman Sanpei. I don't really know how I found this, and I haven't watched that much of it, but for some reason, I just love the way it looks. It's quite old-fashioned, a bit washed out, and very block-coloured, but something about it feels very cozy and nostalgic, even though it was made about 30 years before I was born. I'm not sure, I just thought I'd mention it seeing as I'd found it. So the real question is, what style should I be looking to go for with my animated movie? For those who haven't watched it, you can find out about my film idea in one of my previous videos that I'll link in the description. Seeing as my film is set in a fantasy world, I think it would suit a more colourful style of animation. Plus, as I'm a bit of a sucker for pretty landscape shots, I think I would rather my film be 2D. There's also a couple of artists that I've been looking at, some that I studied at A-level, and some that people in the comment section have suggested that I like the style of. But to be honest, that's as far as I've come really. No, I've not really narrowed it down. I do know that I want my style to be different from anything that I've talked about today, so don't be expecting me to go full anime just yet. I suppose I'll just have to try some different styles out. In the meantime, thanks very much for watching this video. Let me know in the comments what you're thinking of this series so far, or if you have any ideas, it's always nice to see people's suggestions. I'm sorry this video was a bit of a mess. I guess I've just been watching a lot of movies and series that I've ended up really enjoying, and that have got me thinking about a lot of things, but I never quite know how to put those thoughts into words. Anyway, I'm afraid I'm gonna have to love you and leave you. Don't forget to subscribe and check out every single one of my other videos. Just watch all of them. Thank you, and goodbye.